On October 6, 1789, Queen Marie Antoinette and King Louis XVI left Versailles to move to the Tuileries Palace in Paris, never to return. Today, we'll take a look at the events causing this fatal decision. When Queen Marie Antoinette awoke on the morning of October 6, 1789, in her bed at Versailles, she had had a bad night's sleep. The day before, on the morning of October 5, 1789, a group of market women in Paris started protesting against the high bread prices and the scarcity of bread in the French capital. The demonstration quickly developed into an angry mob of thousands of people who rebelled against the old regime for various reasons. Cheered on by revolutionaries, the demonstrators looted weapons and headed for the Palace of Versailles. It took the crowd 6 hours to traverse the distance of 20 kilometers between Paris and Versailles, and along the way, the group of demonstrators grew larger. The march was led by the Marquis de Lafayette, who was the head of the National Guard, as he hoped to contain the situation if he marched along. After the procession's arrival at Versailles at 6:30 p.m., the president of the Constituent Assembly, Jean-Joseph Mounier, accompanied a group of 6 market women delegated by the masses to go to the chateau and speak with Louis XVI. The king listened to the women, showing great sympathy, and made such a good impression on them that their 17-year-old spokeswoman, Pierre Chabrie, fainted, to which the king rushed to her aid. Agreements were made and demands were met. Furthermore, Louis ordered the royal storehouses to be opened to feed the crowd. But the crowd was restless and not satisfied. They had little faith in the king's promises and did not leave Versailles. At around 11 p.m., the king and queen attempted to leave Versailles and flee to Normandy. The National Guard, however, detained the royal carriages before they could be brought to the chateau. At around 6 a.m. on October 6, fights broke out in the streets of Versailles, who had spent the night at bonfires, and the bodyguards. The bodyguards retreated to the chateau, but some protesters discovered a small unguarded palace gate and managed to enter in search of the queen's sleeping quarters. The royal bodyguards rushed to lock doors and barricade corridors in order to try to prevent the protesters from entering further into the palace. But when the bodyguards fired on the intruders, killing a young protester, a furious crowd breached the gates and poured into the palace. Queen Marie Antoinette, aware of the great danger she was in, ran barefoot and half undressed to the king's sleeping quarters, where she pounded on the locked doors. After a few agonizing minutes, the door was opened and she narrowly escaped the angry mob. In order to defuse the volatile situation, Lafayette urged the king, the queen, and their children to go out onto the balcony to address the crowd. Lafayette succeeded in getting the crowd to applaud the queen, as Lafayette respectfully kissed her hand. The people demanded, however, for the royal couple to move to Paris. The king gestured that he agreed. At around 1:30 p.m. on October 6, 1789, a very remarkable procession headed from Versailles to Paris. The National Guard marched ahead with bread stuck onto the bayonets of the guardsmen. Then followed the women, some of them mounted on cannons, others in carriages, and others on foot, along with men from the suburbs armed with whatever they could. Next came the flower wagons seized at Versailles, and finally the carriage carrying the royal family. The women danced and sang, "We will no longer be without bread. We are bringing the baker, the baker's wife, and the little baker to Paris." The royal couple would never return to Versailles. In the following years, the chateau was partially looted by revolutionaries and remained largely empty. Thank you for watching.